What's up, my Moon Tribe? I'm Haley. Welcome back to Moon Tribe Tarot. This is going to be for the star sign of Virgo for December 10th to the 20th of December 2020. Take what resonates and leave behind what does not. If you'd like to book a personal reading with me, where your messages will 100% correlate to your story because they are specifically for you in mind, you can, you can find all the information how to reach me for a reading in the description box down below. If you like the content that I make and you would like to support me, please go smash the like and subscribe button. Without any further ado, I've already gone and pulled your cards off camera, like always for you, Virgo. So let's get right into the reading. We got the Seven of Swords, we got the Two of Swords, and then we got the Seven of Pentacles. So breaking this right down, the Seven of Swords represents a period. Not period. It represents a person that is a fox. They are cunning. They are deceptive. They are sneaky. This is a person that is backstabbing, manipulating, cheating. At the very least, they would be doing something to withhold the truth from you. They are a sneaky fox. Cunning. Because this happened and it was caught, because you directly know that this has happened, because we have you coming in with the Two of Swords, not really knowing what the fuck to do about it. It represents, should I go or should I stay? I could almost toss a coin and that would have to be what breaks this tie for me, because I don't know. I really care about this person. I really don't know if this is the final straw. Is that enough for me to go, or do I continue to stay? My advice for you is I am never, 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 never going to tell you to stay in a toxic situation ever. I'm never going to suggest, if this person cheated on you, if this person manipulated, gaslit, if this person is abusive to you, I'm never going to tell you, yeah, go ahead and do it. However, if this is a situation where nothing like that happened, where this person is healthy for you and they did something like they withheld bank account information, they withheld something that might have been very annoying, but it wasn't hurtful or deceitful to your person, it's not something that would have, if it's something that you can still build on with this person and you would like to, and this person has not been physical or mentally abusive to you, then please continue to do it. However, if, okay, I can't even say that. That's up to you. You get to decide, because you still haven't decided. If you would like to, and it is safe to, by all means. If it's not safe, I'm never going to recommend that, and I'm going to recommend that you don't stay around in that. However, for those of you that still don't know what the hell is going on, it's going to be a hard tie to break. And the honest answer that I got for this is, it's going to be something that you need to figure out over a period of time. So I see this as needing patience. I also kind of view this as, it's potential that some of you are going to want to continue to make this work, but you're going to be very patient with this person. So I kind of see this as forgiving and trying to move on for some of you. For the rest of you, I think that it is kind of maybe separating yourself slightly and kind of trying to work on yourself and see what happens and what unfolds, being very, very patient in this situation. I see you having a lot of patience. I see you handling this in a very mature, responsible way, Virgo. Honestly, I do. I think that you're going to be emotionally responsible about this. So let's see where this goes. Where does this go between Virgo and their Seven of Swords person? Okay, there is, for a large majority of you, going to be the possibility of seeing where you can go from here. It's going to be either choosing to continue to have them in your life and saying, listen, we need to make this work together. It takes two to tango, so you need to be, you know, 50-50 with me on this. We have to go in equally. But if this is something that you would like to do and you are able to do it, it's something that wasn't toxic for you and it's something that can still be had, then by all means, this is great energy. If this is something that you can still foster and you want to, this is good. This is really good. It means that eventually you're going to get to a point where you and your person are going to at least try to start in some vein. It doesn't even have to be if they were romantic with you, that they have to continue that way. You could still be having them in their life, but for a friendship. But I do see progress coming in, stability at least stability, because it's either financial gain or prosperity, and stability and prosperous. So I definitely think that you have a chance at making this work with your person. It's going to take time. Whatever they did to you is going to hurt a little bit, and I think that you need to kind of slow things down and see where you can go. I do think that because I said that very solidly, that I'm not reading for toxicity, that for those of you that this isn't toxic, it has the chance to start again and start somewhere fresh and new. And this is really good for working kinks out. Just be aware that this person has done this once before. Be careful of the fox. And put your truth down, put your boundaries down, make sure that your truth is out there for what you exactly need. And if it can be worked together, that's perfect. I think that's what's going to be happening here for you, Virgo. This is really good energy for the most part. Some of this is not so much, but I think where it goes is good. So this is really good for you, Virgo. I will see you on the flip side. Peace out. Bye.